Hello everyone, so it's Julien again from Saveurs, and it's been quite a while now, we haven't done anything, but today, because it's Christmas soon, in our family traditionally, we are doing a Spanish brioche, which is called the Mona. We've flavored with orange zest and dark rum. It's delicious, very light, not too sweet, so we're gonna make this Spanish brioche. So basically, just to start, we need 25 grams of fresh yeast. 25. I got it. Yes. Just to say. Then warm water. Warm water, I'm not sure how much. Okay, now let's do 150 of warm water. There. So that's gonna help to dissolve the yeast. Voilà. It will help to make it react much quicker. So that's gonna be the starter. Then we've put 250 of a strong flour. Oops, mistake. 250. There. So that's gonna be the starter, and we're gonna let it rise for 2 hours. Oh, what a mess. I should have used the spatula first of all. Stupido. Okay. Well, to be honest, it's not enough water. So if you start actually with 25 grams of yeast, 200 grams of water, and 250 of strong flour, that will do your starter. Yeah, much better. I don't know. Voilà, and this mixture, well, when once it's all mixed, we let it rest for 2 hours in a warm place, and then we carry on the recipe. Okay, so now the starter has been proved, you can see, after resting in a warm place at least for 2 hours. So basically, now we're gonna finish the brioche dough. So for that, I'm gonna use my big mixer because it's a big recipe. You can always divide it for you. Right. So basically, I'm gonna pour my starter in there. First thing. It smells very yeasty. It's a beautiful brioche. I love it. Okay, then. Ooh. It looks like a bit boogie, isn't it? Then. We crack 6 eggs. Without the shell. Well, if you want some crunch, put some shell. There we go. Then we need some sugar. We go for 250. There. Strong flour. 750 gram. So yeah, you can always divide the recipe in two or even three. There. Voilà. Then we need to melt some butter. Well, we can do that in a minute. First, we need the zest. So orange zest. One orange. It was a tiny orange, so maybe a little bit more. Okay, let's say two orange, small, and one large, with a thick skin. This one is very thin skin. There. And some dark rum. Orange and dark rum is so beautiful combination. Basically, I should need a glass. I'm not sure about the quantity, so we're gonna find out now. Of dark rum. That should do. So that with that we can mix it with a hook. First bit slowly. Okay, so now we need some butter, 175 gram. And which we're gonna melt in the microwave, but it have to stay quite cold, not too hot. So just melted. There, in the microwave. Okay, now, whisk, 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 there. The butter is melted and not hot at all, okay? And that's gonna go into the dough. Voilà, very slowly. It smells delicious. Voilà. And we're gonna let it spin and spin and spin until the dough forms a ball and is not sticking to the ball. Ball everywhere. Okay, voilà. That's done. Okay. Now, if you see that Mona, the dough is well mix, it doesn't stick the sides of the bowl. It's beautiful, nice and smooth. silky. This one smells delicious. There we go. So that dough can rest in the fridge as well. Yeah. It's very soft. Et voilà. So we're gonna let it rest and then ready to bowl. Okay, so our brioche dough had a rest. It would be nice to let it rest a bit longer until the next day, but because we want to do it, I don't think it will damage anything if we do it now. It had a good 3 hours in the fridge. I should do. There. It's so soft, it's so beautiful. It's like a woman breast. Okay. So we're just gonna weight it up like 300 gram. We're gonna make some 300 gram bowl. The smell is really amazing. Two, four, six. Let's divide that in six. Chuk, chuk, chuk. Okay, now we're gonna bowl it. So if you take your dough like that, little bit of flour underneath, and then all the outside come inside. You see, in the middle, and you press it, you take, you press it, you take, you press it. When you come to this stage, you just turn it around and bowl it. Between your two hands. Et voilà. It's beautiful. Same for this one. Outside, inside. Turn it around. This help for the strength in the oven, yeah? Voilà. Beautiful little bubbles. Okay, then on a tray, baking tray, and we're gonna let it prove. It should rise 3 times this quantity, so they're gonna come out like that, hopefully. If we did a good job, is what should happen. Voilà, in the prover, and we see what happened. Up. There we go. See you later. Okay, so they've been proved for 30 degrees. They doubled the volume. Up. Now we're gonna glaze them with blitz egg. Yeah. To give them a beautiful shine. And then you, myself, I stick some nibbed sugar. This is our family tradition, really, to put nibbed sugar. But I'm not sure if you can find them very easily. So maybe we could put our granulated sugar or maybe demerara. I never tried, just to give a bit of crunch. And because the brioche is not that sweet, it's nice to have this sweetness on the outside. So let's try. I never tried like that. We'll see what happened. Why not? But the proper one is this one. Nib sugar. You need quite a lot, it's beautiful. Ah. And now we're gonna bake them 160 degrees for until it's cooked. When you get nice shine, nice color, they will be done. Oh, that will be interesting, this one. Voilà. Okay, so they should be ready. They got a nice golden color. So basically, they could have more rest. The dough could have rest a bit more. We did rush it a bit too much, so it did create cracks. It's a little bit heavier than what it should be, but I'll be honest with you. Voilà. That's a kind of what we are expecting. Is voilà. If you rest the dough a bit longer in the fridge before to boil it, it will be much lighter. Voilà, but so our mistake, but it sounds quite good. And with this sugar, it makes a quite nice crusty crust. So yeah, very interesting. And it smells delicious. Voilà. Let's try the piece. Ah, it's not too bad. And this one. Mmm, it's quite nice with this. Mmm. That's all.